God. Oh, my head.
Answer me that. Just answer me that! Your whole family. Your whole blood. What the hell were you thinking? What in the hell crossed your mind? What is happening to you? You've ruined our family. What am I going to do now?
No. This can't be happening. God.
Dad?
I have to find the handle. You are not my son! You are not my son!
Come on. Maybe I can get out through Grandpa's house. I gotta get out of here. I need to find a way out. Isn't there a door here? My birthday present? How did it get here? Something to hang it with. Thank you. won't be able to go back. Must be broken. Thank you. What the hell has Dad been doing here? Dad said he was repairing Grandpa's house, but instead he's been investigating this woman? What is going on? My notebook. So Dad's the one who took it away from me. Grandpa's house. I haven't been here since he died. Fuck. This storm must have taken out the power. I think Grandpa had a generator in the basement. Pipes must be clogged. So nice having both houses connected. We were able to have breakfast with Grandpa every morning. I don't think I can reach that. It's too high up. Grandpa dedicated his whole life to clockmaking. Thank you.
first contact, it is already too late. When a demon attaches itself to a human...
Demons?
It becomes a parasite of sorts. It feeds from the host until it devours every last part of their soul. In most instances, the demon's relentless objective is to get back to the world of the living. If you
what
want to break that
about?
Link, well, I'm afraid it's no simple matter. I could speak at length about various rituals and procedures, but by far the best way is to obey. Help the demon attain that which it seeks. Only then will the demon leave of its own accord. Usually they enter the earthly plane through certain objects that they use as conduits between worlds. Even if you rid yourself of that object later, the demon has made the contact it needs. And already walks among us. In the first stages of possession, the host human tends to withdraw from friends and family, becoming aggressive,
so Dad thinks...
even violent. This is the result of the spiritual battle between the host and the entity, both vying for control over the mortal body. The symptoms that indicate that the possession is progressing are dizziness, nausea, and headaches. The latter of which can be so intense as to render the host unconscious for days. The dark entity manipulates its host with visual hallucinations and voices in the mind. Destroying the sanity of the host is for the purpose of making them malleable, compliant. This is how the demon fully exerts its insidious control. Oh, and before I forget, several cases of possession saw strange behavioral patterns in nearby insects, cockroaches in particular. My advice, steer clear of the insects.
There's just no way. I can't be possessed. There must be a mistake. Those pictures, that leg, that arm, I didn't do it. Dad thinks it was me, but I... Oh, God. My head. A door. A red door. What's happening to me? Is this what that man was talking about? It can't be happening to me. Could it be the basement door? What is this place? This is impossible. What's wrong with me? Those symbols. I've seen them before.
Oh. 17th, 1987, 5:27 a.m. I am now entering Madison Hill's basement.
Hill? 1987?
I can see there's a sort of well in the center of the room. Looks like it's open. I'm gonna investigate further, see what's on the other side of this. God! There's a horrendous smell coming from down here. Oh, God. I almost can't take it. Time to make things worse so I can't see a goddamn thing down here. Madison? Is that you? Please! Show yourself! That's an order!
Why is this happening to me? I gotta get the hell out of... Oh, it hurts. The attic? I don't understand. My head. Gotta find a way to open this door if I want to get out of this house.
A three-year-old woman was killed.
Grandpa's room. What a mess. The entrance key should be somewhere. What are these things? Thank you. she was so sick. Definitely someone here.
Becoming possessed by a wicked entity is signified by loss of control over the body, mind, and the soul. However, that is often not enough for the entity. It hungers for more. Things get much worse for the host. In these cases, possession is just the first step of the demon's plan. It is said there are those that return to our world seeking to resolve unfinished matters from their mortal lives. Victims of these wicked possessions are subjected to a departure of sorts. An astral transportation, for lack of a better word.
An astral what?
These malicious beings force their hosts to live moments that shouldn't be possible in a different place and time. Perhaps even in a different dimension altogether. It's madness. It's unclear whether these transportations occur inside the mind, or if the host is physically taken to some alternative reality.
Alternative reality? I'm losing my mind. That's no signal.
Thank you.
These photos are pretty old. Thank you. So Grandpa tried to contact Grandma with this thing? Is that blood? There are handprints on the walls. The handprints stopped. How did I get here? I hate graveyards.